Hello, my name is Nitin. Today is a big day as I am going to test the most significant development in vector array system technology since the official introduction of cSAR3D in 2013, that is cSAR3D version 5.0. Apparently, version 5.0 comes with a 10 times faster data acquisition, data processing and visualization speed, which is a little sensation in itself. Shpia claims that the update rate of full specific absorption rate assessment is now much better than 0.4 seconds. This would mean that the cSAR3D is more than 20 times faster than any other vector array system on the market. This is exciting news as the advancement allows for completely new test features such as quasi-real-time volume evaluations of the Time-Averaged SAR or TAS algorithm. This feature is actually released together with cSAR3D version 5.0. On top of this, Shpiag has also extended the frequency range from 300 MHz to 10 GHz. Today, I will test the speed of cSAR3D version 5.0 and the new TAS features with these two mobile phones of the latest generation. cSAR3D version 5.0 offers two methods to evaluate the TAS. The first one, called the PSR, time average SAR, simply averages the peak spatial SAR values at every time point, which works perfectly for the classic TAS implementation, as we will see in a moment. The second method is a more advanced one called volume time average SAR that is universally valid. It first averages the SAR at every point in the phantom before it computes the peak average SAR value. The volume time average SAR method will work for uplink MIMO based TAS or TAS enabled proximity sensors or even with multi-channel aggregation. So let's start with this 5G phone. It contains a dynamic TAS control algorithm in the 2.4 GHz hotspot mode. As a comparison for later, I start with a standard single SAR measurement by disabling TAS and setting the device to maximum power. You can actually already notice in this step how much faster the response time is. Next, I start the TAS evaluator and set the averaging parameters. In this example, I set the averaging time to 100 seconds and the measurement duration to 600 seconds. I then start the PSR time averaged TAS measurement with this button here. I enable TAS on the phone with the hotspot mode. And now look at the plot. I get nearly 3 updates per second. This includes acquisition, reconstruction, averaging, and visualization of the results. This means that any fast variations in device SAR will also be precisely captured and included in the TAS calculations. On the TAS window, we see the plot of instantaneous SAR values versus time in seconds. The thick red line on the plot shows the 1 gram TAS value. All these values are updated 3 times per second. Not only that, but also the SAR pattern is updated at the same speed. The current PSR 1 gram 10 gram TAS values are shown in the upper right corner, while the maximum TAS from the start of the measurement is shown in the upper corner of the measurement window. As the averaging window length is 100 seconds, we see meaningful values of TAS after 100 seconds. We can see that after 100 seconds, the TAS value converges to a certain level. The device power control algorithm neatly maintains the time average SAR within this limit. I will now accelerate the video. Once the measurements are finished, the maximum time average SAR is shown in the Lilly's diagram and also in the results display here. The 2D plot can be accessed by clicking on the measurement in the Lilly's or also via the measurement properties. Once measurements of TAS are done, these can be re-evaluated for a different averaging window. For instance, I will look at the 10 gram TAS with the averaging window set to 150 seconds. It is also possible to look at the instantaneous SAR pattern for any of the individual measurements through the 2D plot flow distribution option. So now, let's look at the other device that implements TX antenna switching. It has two LTE antenna, one on the top here and the other at the bottom. The switching occurs based on the downlink signal strength or quality received by the two antennas. I will set up the device for LTE band 41 and start the TAS measurement on cSAR3D in PSR time average TAS mode and afterwards reevaluate in volume TAS mode. The PSR time average TAS measurement is now running. I quickly shift the downlink antenna from one side to the other, causing the device to switch the antennas from top of the phone to the bottom. The cool part is that cSAR3D precisely captures the antenna switching and includes those in its TAS calculation. This is really important as modern devices now support antenna switching in addition to the dynamic power control feature. The maximum PSR value is 1.12 watt per kg for 1 gram. Now, I will reevaluate the same measurement with the volume TAS method. This will provide the most realistic estimate of TAS without overestimation. In this mode, at any point in the phantom volume, the SAR is time averaged, and from that, the SAR distribution and the peak spatial SARs are calculated. As you can see, the resulting peak spatial SAR is now 0.829 watt per kg, which is 1.3 dB below the value obtained by the PSR mode. This is really impressive, and the feature itself is extremely easy to use. However, I want to make an additional test with two antennas operating at two frequencies positioned with an overlapping SAR pattern. I mounted two dipoles, one operating at 2300 MHz and the other at 2600 MHz closely together. The dipoles are fed with two independent signal generators controlled by a Python script. The first one transmits pulses at 2300 MHz with plus 17 dBm output power and a 5 second on-off interval. The other transmits pulses at 2600 MHz with plus 14 dBm and a 20 second interval. The two dipoles thus transmit with a 50% duty cycle. I have established the target value before by measuring each antenna individually with 50% power and combine the two measurements using the combiner. The combined values are 1.27 watt per kg for 1 gram and 0.599 watt per kg for 10 gram. That is now the target value for this test. Next, I start the Python script to feed the dipoles with pulses and then start the PSR time average TAS measurement in the cSAR3D software. Now the 2600 MHz dipole is switched on. Now both. And now only the 2300 MHz dipole. I accelerate the video. The measurement is now finished. Now I will reevaluate the same with volume TAS method. The final measured TAS values for this test configuration are 1.33 watt per kg 1 gram and 0.63 watt per kg 10 gram. The deviation to the target values is thus less than 0.2 dB, even though I measured at two frequencies simultaneously. This shows the power of cSAR3D version 5.0. SPIAG mentioned that they will even extend the simultaneous transmission features in the upcoming version 5.2. I am amazed. cSAR3D version 5.0 is a real breakthrough, opening new evaluation possibilities such as for dynamic SAR management features. For example, for systems combining TAS proximity sensor technology, all features work smoothly for the entire extended frequency range from 300 MHz up to 10 GHz. Thanks for watching this video.